privilege to welcome you here today. Just a couple of quick housekeeping things. There are restrooms just on either side of these doors here, and a larger set of restrooms located in our office building just down this breezeway, if you ever need them, and exits in all three doors in the back and over here as well. Today you get to hear a really wonderful program played by a longtime friend of mine, Dr. Lynn Trapp of St. Joseph Catholic Church in Baltimore, Maryland. I've known Lynn for, almost 10 years now. It just so happens that Lynn was the director of music at St. Olaf Catholic Church in downtown Minneapolis, where I spent my post-college years, and my twin sister worked with Dr. Trapp while we lived there, and she worked with him at St. Olaf, and I'm really thrilled to have him back here today. He's the director of music and liturgy there, and he's got a really fantastic and dynamic program for us, so please, without further ado, please help me welcome Dr. Lynn Trapp.
Thank you.
Once again, good afternoon and welcome to Trinity Cathedral here in downtown Portland. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Katie Webb. I'm the canon musician here. We get to do something fun for this particular evensong, the service of choral evensong for Candlemas, or the feast of Jesus' presentation in the temple. And that is, we get to sing in Latin, which is something that we don't get to do very often here at the cathedral. So if you go to your service leaflet on your phone, you'll see the opening procession, and you get to help us sing that opening procession piece. You get to sing the refrain. And so I thought I would take you through it just very briefly so you can join us as we sing it with you. For that Latin, that church Latin pronunciation, please repeat after me. Lumen ad revelationem. Gentium et gloriam plebis tue Israel. So that text is to be a light to lighten the nations and to be the glory of your people Israel in Latin. So the choir will sing it first, and you can copy us, as it were, just back and forth. We'll sing it twice the first time. They'll sing it, then we'll all sing it, and after that we'll just sing it once through each time it says antiphon. So again, you are so welcome here this afternoon. Thank you for joining us.
with you. Let us pray. God our Father, source of all light, today you reveal to the aged Simeon your light which enlightens the nations. Fill our hearts with the light of faith, that we who bear these candles may walk in the path of goodness and come to the light that shines forever, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, make haste to help us.
A reading from the prophet Malachi. See, I am sending my messenger to prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to the temple. The messenger of the covenant in whom you delight, indeed he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who can endure the day of his coming, and who can stand when he appears? For he is like a refiner's fire and like washer's soap. He will sit as a refiner and purifier of silver. He will purify the descendants of Levi and refine them like gold and silver until they present offerings to the Lord in righteousness. Then the offering of Judah and Jerusalem will be pleasing to the Lord, as in the days of old and as in former years. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the Gospel according to Luke. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for the glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed. And a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, then as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped there with fasting and prayer, night and day. At that moment, she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we humbly pray that as your only begotten Son was this day presented in the temple, so we may be presented to you with pure and clean hearts by Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Lord God, whose Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, triumphed over the powers of death and prepared for us our place in the New Jerusalem, grant that we who have this day given thanks for his resurrection may praise thee in that city of which he is the light, and where he liveth and reigneth forever and ever.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night. Give thine angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ. Give rest to the weary. Bless the dying. Soothe the suffering. Pity the afflicted. Shield the joyous. And all for thy love's sake.
Well, happy Candlemas, or maybe blessed Candlemas is a better greeting for today. We're celebrating the Feast of the Presentation of our Lord. The date for this feast is obviously February 2nd, but it's celebrated on the Sunday closest. This is one of the oldest feast days in the Christian calendar. It's also known as the Feast of the Purification or the Meeting of our Lord. And historically, this was the end of the Christmas season. And many people still observe that custom today. It's 40 days after Christmas, the day we celebrate the birth of Jesus. And according to Jewish custom, 40 days after birth was the day that baby boys were presented to be named, and the day their mothers went to be purified after giving birth. And so we just heard this story, right, from the Gospel of Luke, the story of Mary and Joseph's visit to the temple and the reactions of Simeon and Anna when they encountered the baby Jesus. And this is an important story for us Christians, so important that Simeon's words have become their own canticle or song, the Nunc Dimittis, and we just heard that a few moments ago. We hear it every evensong. It's part of our common liturgical language. Jesus is the light of the world. Now, people in the Northern Hemisphere have been celebrating something or other at this time of year for millennia. We're roughly halfway between the winter solstice and the spring equinox. So it's a time of year when we're anxious to shrug off the dark sleep of winter and embrace the new life of spring, even though we know we'll have to wait a little while yet, depending on what the groundhog tells us. There's something that these many festivals and observances have in common is light. Searching for light, looking forward to the return of light in longer days. So here we are this evening with a bunch of candles, and we're celebrating Jesus' presentation in the temple. Simeon and Anna recognize that this baby was special. Anna begins praising God as soon as she sees the baby. And Simeon declared him to be the light to lighten the Gentiles, or the light of revelation to the Gentiles, the glory of Israel. Jesus is declared by two prophets when he is still just a baby to be the light. Light is an important part of our worship practice. We almost always use candles, and we often make a point of lighting those candles while everyone can watch. Those bearing the light, the acolytes, are given a special place and a role in worship. The light of the candles represents for us the light of Christ, Jesus, present with us in this space. But it's not just the light of Jesus that we celebrate today. We all carry that spark within us, that light, that divine spark. When we are baptized here in the Episcopal Church, we receive a candle, and we are told, receive this candle as a sign that you have passed from darkness into light. Shine as Christ's light in the world to the glory of God. Words that are quite similar to what we heard Simeon say about Jesus to his parents. So you carry that light within you. And the world needs your light. Those around us, those of us around you, need your light of love, of kindness, of justice. No one else can shine the way you do. The world needs your light, and your light, and your light, and mine. Wonderful things happen when you share your light. The light spreads. On Christmas Eve, hearkening back to Christmas, while we sang Silent Night, the light of one candle spread throughout this whole room. One candle lit another and another, and soon the whole room was glowing. Some of you choristers, you were here. Do you remember when everyone out there held up their candles and all the children who were up here in the pageant just gasped? It was breathtaking to look out there and see all of that light. And that's the way it works out there in the world too. One heart touching another with love. One light shining in hope for others to see. We celebrated this same occasion this morning in Church of the Commons, our family service over in Kempton Hall. We had the same readings, and our very young reader read the gospel for us. And when he got to the part that said, the light of revelation to the Gentiles, he mispronounced a word, and what he said was, a light of revolution to the Gentiles. And it was so perfect, because that's what Jesus is, right? Jesus is the light of revolution, a revolution of love, a revolution of justice. That's what he was all about. And so we bless the candles here today to be that light. Take that blessing home with you today. Let those candles remind you not only of the light of Christ Jesus, but also of the light within you. Take this blessing and the light out into the world and shine.
Dear people of God, let us celebrate and let us bear witness to the light that exceeds every imagination. Make us disciples of every nation, bringing baptism to those we meet on the journey. We lift our hearts to you, O God, and remember before you those who are suffering from poor health of any kind. We pray for our friends, our family members, neighbors, and those unknown to us, those who this very night are battling disease, infirmity, and death. Be present, Lord Christ, to all those who cry to you for help. Answer their cries. Bestow your mercy of healing and health upon them. In the name of God, the Creator and Mother of us all. Amen. We cast our hopes upon the promise of God's beloved community, that all political leaders may preserve, protect, and increase the well-being of their people, especially that of the poor, the elderly, the powerless, and the dispossessed. Protect and sustain those who are affected by war and injustice. We pray for the leaders of the world and for our Supreme Court, Congress, and President, and for those who seek election, that a conviction for God's mercy will prevail upon their hearts and minds. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Redeemer, amen. Finally, O Lord, in this time when many are suffering from hunger, homelessness, financial insecurity, poor health, and unemployment, we pray for those who are shut in, those sleeping on our streets, those battling addiction, and those losing hope, that the hope of the needy never be taken away. Grant that every one of us may enjoy a fair portion of the riches of this land. In the name of God, whose Spirit leads us to our greater selves. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God